I was ready to be a mom.
It brought a lot of excitement to me just because I always fantasized to have a family in the future. I've been in the foster care system since I was a baby. So I always strive to do everything I can for my family.
I really didn't start having any real issues till like 7 months.
We knew something was wrong, but wasn't for sure. Her overswelling, how big the baby was getting inside, even from our ultrasounds.
He came out not breathing. And after that, I just had a team of doctors come in and tell me pretty much my baby was not normal.
When Josiah was born, the providers recognized that the circumference of his head was disproportionate to his body. Of megalencephaly or macrocephaly with a staining pattern of capillary malformation has been clinically termed MCAP or MCM. These are conditions that are driven by variants in a gene called PIK3CA that tell these cells to grow, overgrow. These can be isolated and sequenced, and the clinical and the genetic come together to help make this diagnosis. The pediatric community has been treating these patients forever. You know, perhaps they haven't known the exact name for the condition or the pathophysiology of what drives these lesions, but they know the parts of the whole, and they can spot functionally impactful lesions. But it is always frustrating to know how to navigate a system. Where do you send patients to?
I had a crew come in. I don't know who they were, but they worked for the hospital, and they pretty much asked me if I was going to care for my son, and if not, they would find him a home. I couldn't do that. I loved him, just the way he was. I didn't care how much medicine he needed. I just wanted to know what it was so that I could make sure that my son was getting exactly the care he needed.
Josiah was born out of state, and he only recently established care at Children's Colorado. The Vascular Anomalies Center is a medical home for complex kids that require care from multiple providers at the same time. A definitive surgery to remove parts of the brain that trigger epileptic seizures is not uncommon in MCAP or MCM.
Josiah did really well. He needed it. Like, you could just tell from his face that after the surgery, it was like, wow, like, I feel better. I can move my head. I don't know. It was like a whole different child. It's really awesome to know that my kid has overcame all these things. And now we're here, and we're going to keep going and going until we meet all of his goals.
This is a field ripe for the understanding of the genetic drivers and targeted therapies that could change this field. I'm hopeful when I think of Josiah that he will be able to experience a world of targeted and personalized therapy. I'd like to think that going forward, MCM is going to see some changes and that it is the younger children, it is Josiah, that should benefit the most from those interventions.
I can see that he's progressing a lot, and I really believe that miracles can happen. He walks around like he just owns the place. And his personality is just amazing. And I can just tell that he's gonna grow up to be a really good man.